Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Times Up Ummah. Today's first news update is coming from Turkey, where a joint statement from Afghanistan, Pakistan and Turkish foreign ministers issued after talks in Istanbul on Friday. The three ministers underlined the urgent need for an immediate ceasefire to end the violence and provide a conducive atmosphere for peace talks. Dear viewers, three countries have called on Taliban to reaffirm its commitment to achieve a negotiated settlement for lasting peace in Afghanistan. Dear viewers, the United States backed Afghan peace conference was set to be hosted in Istanbul by Turkey, Qatar and the United Nations on 24th of April was postponed because Taliban was refused to attend the meeting after United States' decision to withdraw its forces by September 11. Turkey has said the talks will be held after the Islamic fasting month of Ramadan, but yet no new date has been set. The Turkish foreign minister said Ankara's support for the Afghan peace process and supports to organize the conference in Istanbul will be continued. As the co-organizers, we are continuing talks on this with all sides. According to the joint statement, the ministers called on all parties, in particular the Taliban, to reaffirm their commitment for achieving an inclusive negotiated settlement leading to lasting peace in Afghanistan, desired by the Afghan people, the region and the international community. Dear viewers, the Afghan issue has now in a turning point and anything can be happen, like civil war or a long-awaited peace. The second news update is coming from Iran, where Iran has suspended flights from Iran to India and Pakistan, and also from India and Pakistan to Iran, because coronavirus cases in India drastically increasing. Dear viewers, Iran is now facing fourth wave of coronavirus and have enforced strict restrictions in most of its cities. The move comes after Iran's health ministry suggested that it should ban flights, since it said the coronavirus strain found in India could pose a much graver risk than the variant first found in the UK, which has now become dominant in Iran. President Hassan Rouhani said, "Now we face a new threat, that is Indian virus, which is worse than the English, Brazilian and the South African ones." He warned and said, "If this virus also entered to country, we will face a major problem." Dear viewers, till now, Iran has reported 69,000 deaths and 2.3 million people have been infected by coronavirus. On the other side, India have reported 346,000 new cases and 2,624 deaths in the previous 24 hours, which has broke all records, and total number of infected people has surpassed 16.5 million. And the most worst news is, in every 4 minutes, one victim facing death due to coronavirus. Today's third news update is coming from Iran, where Iran has wrote a letter to the Council of European Union and formally protested against the blacklisting of several individuals and entities. The letter comes in response to the European Union decision on April 12, which sanctioned 8 military commanders and police chiefs, in addition to a 3 prison for their role in a deadly crackdown on public protests in November 2019 that Amnesty International said led to at least 304 deaths. Dear viewers, European Union has now blacklisted 89 individuals and 4 entities as a part of decade-long human rights sanctions regime against who it says are violating human rights in Iran. The Iranian foreign minister, in response to the European Union sanctions, said it will immediately suspend talks with the European Union human rights and all resulting cooperation, including that on terrorism, illicit drugs and refugees. It also traced political intentions behind the move and said it is considering reciprocal sanctions. The letter also says that a number of European Union member states have imposed intentional damage on the health and well-being of Iranian people, particularly children, women, the elderly and the persons with disability. Iran accused the European Union of supporting Donald Trump's unilateral sanctions that was imposed on Iran after walking out from 2015 deal. The European Union spokesman for foreign affairs said it would be wrong to claim the European Union has supported United States sanctions on Iran. He added, quite the contrary, the European Union repeatedly rejected the unilateral impositions of the United States sanctions and prevented United States efforts under the Donald Trump administration to reintroduce United Nations sanctions on Iran. Viewers, if you want to watch top news of each day, please subscribe Times Up Ummah.